Story 1 of Two Poe Tales. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information, or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Recording by Catherine Eastman. Two Poe Tales. Story 1. How to Write a Blackwood Article. In the name of the Prophet, figs! Cry of the Turkish fig peddler. I presume everybody has heard of me. My name is the Signora Psyche Zenobia. This I know to be a fact. Nobody but my enemies ever calls me Suki Snobs. I have been assured that Suki is but a vulgar corruption of Psyche, which is good Greek, and means the soul. That's me, I'm all soul, and sometimes a butterfly, which latter meaning undoubtedly alludes to my appearance in my new crimson satin dress, with the sky-blue Arabian mantelet, and the trimmings of green agraffas, and the 7 flounces of orange-colored auriculas. As for Snobs, any person who should look at me would be instantly aware that my name wasn't Snobs. Miss Tabitha Turnip propagated that report through sheer envy. Tabitha Turnip, indeed! Oh, the little wretch! But what can we expect from a turnip? Wonder if she remembers the old adage about blood out of a turnip, etc. Memorandum. Put her in mind of it the first opportunity. Memoranda again. Pull her nose. Where was I? Ah, I have been assured that Snobs is a mere corruption of Zenobia, and that Zenobia was a queen. So am I. Dr. Moneypenny always calls me the Queen of the Hearts. And that Zenobia, as well as Psyche, is good Greek, and that my father was a Greek, and that, consequently, I have a right to our patronymic, which is Zenobia, and not by any means Snobs. Nobody but Tabitha Turnip calls me Suki Snobs. I am the Signora Psyche Zenobia. As I said before, everybody has heard of me. I am that very Signora Psyche Zenobia, so justly celebrated as corresponding secretary to the Philadelphia Regular Exchange Teetotal Young Bells Letters Universal Experimental Bibliographical Association to Civilize Humanity. Dr. Moneypenny made the title for us, and says he chose it because it sounded big, like an empty rum puncheon. A vulgar man, that, sometimes. But he's deep. We all sign the initials of the society after our names, in the fashion of the RSA, Royal Society of Arts, the SDUK, Society for the Diffusion of Useful Knowledge, etc., etc. Dr. Moneypenny says that S stands for stale, and that DUK spells duck, but it don't. That SDUK stands for Stale Duck, and not for Lord Brougham's Society. But then Dr. Moneypenny is such a queer man that I am never sure when he is telling me the truth. At any rate, we always add to our names the initials PRETTYBLUEBATCH, that is to say, Philadelphia Regular Exchange Teetotal Young Bell Lettre Universal Experimental Bibliographical Association to Civilize Humanity, one letter for each word, which is a decided improvement upon Lord Brougham. Dr. Moneypenny will have it that our initials give our true character, but for my life I can't see what he means. Notwithstanding the good offices of the doctor, and the strenuous exertions of the association to get itself into notice, it met with no very great success until I joined it. The truth is, the members indulged in too flippant a tone of discussion. The papers read every Saturday evening were characterized less by depth than buffoonery. They were all whipped syllabub. There was no investigation of first causes, first principles. There was no investigation of anything at all. There was no attention paid to that great point, the fitness of things. In short, there was no fun.
Sample complete. Ready to continue?